today we will discuss the QPSK. So last class we have discussed about the BPSK. So basically in the BPSK we have seen we transmit a single bit at a time. So when we are doing that, that time we reduce the probability error. But along with this probability of error, the bandwidth also a very crucial to consider. So to improve that bandwidth in the sense the data rate means the same. Suppose we have a 1 hertz bandwidth, previously we send a single bit. So now to if we able to utilize the efficient utilization of channel bandwidth, that means instead of 1 bit, if we are able to send more than 1 bit. So in this process, that one answer is there that we can utilize the bandwidth using the quadri phase shift keying, that QPSK. And the QPSK also is a coherent detection. So basically, so now in this coherent detection, so how many bits we are sending? We are sending 2 bits, which is called the D bit. So a pair of bits is called the D bit. And so if we send a pair of 2 bits, so using the 2 bits, how many combination we can get? We can get
4, sir.
Combination we can get. Okay. So say 0001, and we are writing in order of your gray coding. So in the gray coding, what is there? The consecutive 2 number, there is a single bit of change. That is the main property of the gray coding. So we are doing like this over here. So that means we have 4 combination. So that means we are taking n equal to 2 dimension, and m will be equal to 4. Okay, so now so for that, how many basic function or orthonormal function we require to represent that m equal to 4? Orthonormal equation means phi t. So this is the basic function or orthonormal function. How many of phi t is required for this QPSK? Or when we are considering m equal to 4. So we require the 2, the orthonormal function or basic function. So, and to represent the value of our signal of QPSK signal, so we use this formula. So in this formula, there are 4 phase shift is there, 4 different position of the phase we have considered. And according to that, we will perform the QPSK. So what are the phase we have taken? That for 1 bit pair, this is 0 by pi by 4, second bit pair 3 pi by 4, and third one is 4 pi, and the last one for your 7 pi by 4. So these are the different phase shift we have taken to represent the signal, QPSK signal, that is transmitted through the channel. Okay. And what is the value of E? E is the transmitted signal energy per symbol. T is the symbol duration. So previously, when we discussed about the BPSK, we have considered the EB and TB. Okay. So EB, and since there is only 1 bit was transmitting, so we consider the, okay, the, this is the energy per bit. Okay. But in that case, we are sending a symbols. In a symbol, there are 2 bits. We say D bit. So that's why we represent the E is representing the transmitted signal energy per symbol, and T is symbols duration. And what is the FC? FC is the same as the BPSK. It's the carrier frequency, and it should be equal to the NC by T. Okay. So these are the 4 combination of D bits we have considered. Okay. So now if we want to draw the signal space diagram for the QPSK signal. So now before drawing the signal space diagram, if we do this little bit of trigonometry over here. So we know the cos A, suppose this is A, this is B. So if we know the cos A plus B, so if we expand that thing, that means what will be there? So what is the formula for that cos A plus B? Cos A cos B minus sin A sin B. So that thing we did over here. So that means the transmitted signal is rewritten like this way. Okay. And as I told, that means there is a for four value of I we have, because using this combination we can get the four value. Okay. So now, and we require the two basic function or orthonormal function. One is the phi on t, and the phi on t is equal to square root of 2 by t cos 2 pi f c t, and second is the second phi to t, that's equal to square root of 2 by t sine 2 pi f c t. And what are the range over there? 0 to t. Okay. So, and now if we draw the diagram, the space, signal space diagram for the QPSK signal, so it will be plotted at different position, because this position is indicating, say, this is M1, the message point 1, this is message point 2, message point 3, or message point 4. Okay, and this is the corresponding value of energy, that distance. So we will see later on what are those things. So in this x-axis, basically this is phi 1, this is phi 2. So using these two orthonormal function, we can achieve a four number of region, and for the four number of different region, we have assigned the four different symbols over there. Okay. Okay. So in the two, suppose if we want to represent the what is the two dimensional signal vector, so that we know that in the normally the signal vector is represented by the S of n, si, where n I belongs to 0 to 1 to n. So that means since n equal to 2 over here, that means si will be your 2, means si equal to 2 elements will be there. One element is that, second element is this. Okay. And this is the signal vector that we use, and we are getting this value from that expression. Okay, we know ST, that's equal to your SIT into pi I t. Okay. So okay. So these two value we have. So now the SI is the signal vector and Q is the orthonormal vector, multiply we will get signal. So we know what is the value of this. And so from there we are getting the signal vector after taking the, so from these terms, if we take the Q1 from there, what will be the remaining thing? So that will be the square root of your cos 2i minus 1 into pi by 4 and minus square root of e sine of 2i minus 1 pi by 4. So these two value we are getting from there. Okay. So now if we want to draw the QPSK waveforms, how it will be look like? So take example, we are taking examples. There are 8 bits is there. Okay. And we divided these 8 bits into two sequence. One is called the odd number sequence, polarity of coefficient that your SI1. So that means from there the signal vector, we have two value, so SI1 and SI2. Okay. So for the SI1 and SI2, we have taken the two different coefficient and what should be the bid for the SI1 into phi 1. And second one is the when we are taking the even number of sequence, and that will be the SI2 into phi 2 t. Okay. So from there, that means we can, what we are doing over here, the odd number sequence, that means we are taking the odd number of bits. When we are getting this signal, the odd number sequence, what we are doing, suppose these are the input binary sequence, we are taking the only the odd number position. So suppose this is odd number position, okay, these are the odd number position, so we are taking those value, these value, this value, this value, and this value. These are the odd number position, and this is your even number position. Okay. Okay. So for zero, we are taking, when we are taking this value phi on t. So if we draw the signal, so it will be started from minus pi by pi, and it will be look like this. Okay. For the positive mean 1, so when this value equal to 1, then we are taking from the, since it is a cos function, so it is started from the positive value. For the 0, it will start from the negative cos, okay, and for the 1, it will be the positive cos sign. Okay, so this is continue. And for your even number sequence, what we have taken the even number orthonormal function, we have taken as a sine. So sine has taken the orthonormal function for this. So that means the signal will be your sine. Okay. So now it is a sine wave. So that means we have two things. One is the, when it is 1, then it is a plus sine. And when it is 0, then it is minus. So opposite thing is there. And if we see the sequence over there, so from their odd number, we are getting 0, 1, 1, 0. For your even number, we are getting 1, 0, 0, and 0. So now if we add these two signal, individual signal, then we'll get the ST. This is the message signal, okay, or transmitted signal. So these are the transmitted signal. Now if we look at that graph, there is a theory condition is there. So one condition is that there is a phase shift of 180 degree, okay, and second is that there is a no phase shift. Third one is a phase shift of 90 degree, okay. When we are getting a phase shift of 180 degree, so when there is a two change means, suppose it is changing in this position. Suppose if we consider this point, okay. If we consider this point, there is a two change. One is 0 to 1, and there is a 1 to 0. So when there is a two change, we are getting a 180 degree phase change. So in this position, we are getting a 180 degree phase change. Okay. So now in the second condition, when there is a single change is there. So single change means if we look at that point, In this point, there is a single change. One is 1 to 0 and there is 0 to 0. That means only one changes over there. So we are getting 90 degree of phase shift over there. Okay. And when there is a no change, that means if we look at that point, 1 to 1, 0 to 0, there is a no point. So that means it will continue the signal. There is a no phase change over there. So these three observation we are getting from there. Is there any doubt?
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, is it plus 90 shift or minus 90 shift?
That signal.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So signal. In this point, the 90, it depend on the how it is changing. So the thing is that, suppose if it is here from, say this is 1 to 0, Okay. So in that case, when we are representing the zero bits over here, so the changes over here, it will be your say negative change is there. Now if it is 0 to 1, that means the signal will be your in this position. So we will move over there. So it is depend on the what are the sequence. Similarly, same thing is here. So depending on the after which bit is coming. So if it is your after 1, we are getting 0. In that case, it will be the minus. Okay. And if it is after 0 to 1, yeah, this point also has changed. Suppose this point here 0, 1. And this point also say 1, 1. Suppose. So in that case, what will be the changes over there? So it will be the 90 degrees. So it will be continue over here and it will start it from here. Is that clear? It is depend on the what is the previous bit. Okay. So now we can write this expression ST, that's equal to your SI1 into phi 1t plus SI2 into phi 2t. This is the generalized formula when we discuss about this, the S message signal or transmitted signal. Previously we have seen that equation. Okay. So this is the transmitted signal we are transmitting. And these are the, okay. So, and now in this corresponding value, okay. So basically now if we get the what should be the coordinate and message point, so basically for the four sequence 1 1 0 1 0 0 1 0, so corresponding phase we have considered over here, that for 1 1 it is 5/4, for 0 1 it is 3/5/4, 0 0 4/5/5/4, and 1 0 7/5/4. And corresponding magnitude of the SI1 and SI2. So we have two value only. So that means we will get the SI1 and SI2. And what should be the corresponding value we are getting from there? So square root of plus, because if we put the value over there, suppose this value I equal to 1. So that means, sorry, not there, over here. So for the different value of the I, we'll get the value. So it will basically, it will be the cost in the initial case, it will be the when I equal to 1. So in that case, what is the value? Cos pi by 4. So cos pi by 4 means square root square pi by 4. That means square root of, and cos pi by 4 value 1 by root 2. So that's why we are getting plus square root of E by 2. Similarly, we are getting the value over there. If we put the value, 1, 2, and 3 corresponding value over there. Okay. So for that different position, we'll get the different coordinates. So these coordinates are already pointed over there. Okay, 1, 1, when this value, and 1, 0, 0, 0, and 0, 1. For four combination of this value, we are shown in this space, signal space diagram. Okay. So now how to generate the coherent detection of the QPS signal. So generation, now if we want to generate the QPS signal, so what should be the procedure if we recall the BPSK? So what was the BPSK signal, that generation of the BPSK signal? There was a line coder, encoder, line encoder is there. After that is followed by a line encoder followed by in the binary BPSK. In the binary BPSK, first the signal is there, binary sequence is there. Then there is a line encoder. Then there is a block. So what is that block? Second one was the product modulator, and which was multiplied by the basic function pi on t pi I t. So this thing, and we got the BPSK signal for the BPSK binary phase shifting. So in the QPSK, if we want to generate, so what are the things is there? First, we need to get the two sequence from the binary sequence. So input sequence is there, we need to find out the what sequence and event number of sequence. So for that's why, so the binary sequence we are taking, then we are doing the line coding, then demultiplexer. So basically this demultiplexer will help us to segregate the bit position. So suppose this is your odd number and this is your even number, okay? So these two channel have the two name also, the in phase channel and this is your quadrant channel, okay? So now after segregating these two value, there will be a multiplier module and it will be multiplier is the phi 1 t and second one is the phi 2 t. So if we add up, so if you see this figure, so we get this value, we get this value and we add up these two signal, we are getting the actual signal. So we added over there and we are getting the QPSK signal over there. Okay, so this is the block diagram for generating the QPSK signal. Okay, so now at the receiver, what should be there? So similar to your, the BPSK receiver, we have the same thing. So first, what is there? There is a receive signal SIT. This will be multiply with the phi 1 t and phi 2 t. We will get do the integration over there and then we will get two signals over here, S1 and S2. Okay, then there is a decision level. So based on that, and we have that threshold value of zero. So based on the decision device, we'll take the value and there is a multiplexer. So we'll get the estimated transmitted binary sequence at the output of the receiver. Okay. So is there any doubt in the transmitter how to generate the QPSK signal and demodulate the QPSK signal, or we'll get the estimated transmitted binary sequence? As I told, this first channel, the previous day I already told, this is a in phase channel and this is a quadrature channel. Two channel is we consider for odd and even values. Is there any doubt? No. Okay. So from the figure of the receiver, so what we are, so this is the figure of the receiver. So what is there in the receiver? There is a pair of correlators is there. So in the correlator means, previously we discussed what is the correlator, and a device decision, pair of division device decision is required over here. Sorry. So this is for the receiver only. What I told, the pair of correlator is required. This is a pair of correlator. Together it's called the pair of means correlator two, and correlator is so two pair of, or on a pair of correlator is required over there, and a pair of decision device is there. Then what is the requirement? This is the multiplexer. On multiplexer is there, which will give us the output sequence. So basically, just a minute. Hello. আচ্ছা আমি আপনি আপনি এগারোটার পরে কল করুন, না হলে আরেকজনের নাম্বার আছে সেটাতে কল করুন একবার। ওকে। these are the devices required. Okay. So now we'll discuss about the how to calculate the error probability for the QPSK signal. So it is similar to your BPSK signal. So we'll see when we receive a signal ST, in the ST there is a SIT as well as the WT. So WT is a noise, AWGN noise, and it has a zero means and the noise power spectrum density of N0/2. This is the property of your Gaussian noise. Okay. So now if we want to calculate the value of SI1, so that X1, so we got the two value X1 and X2. So how to calculate the value S1 and S2? So we calculate the value using this formula. S1 equal to integration of 0 to 2 xt into phi 1 t dt. So in this xt is your SI t plus WT. Okay. So from then, if you multiply the phi t, so we'll get that expression. Yes or no? We'll get that expression or not? Put the value of ST over here and we have the phi t. So what is the phi t value? Phi 1 t. So we have taken the phi 1 t equal to your t square root of t by 2 cos of 2 pi fc t. This is a 2 pi fc t cos of, okay, this value we have put over there. And also we will put the value of SI1. So SI1 we have taken from there. What is that value? That SI1, what was the value of SI1? Square root. Are you getting this? How we will get that expression from there? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that means whatever the value of SIT and WT, when we are taking multiply with the WT with the phi 1 t, we will get the W1. When we will multiply the WT with the phi 2, we will get the W2. And the remaining portion will give us that value. So if we put the corresponding value, we will get the plus minus depending on the different value of phi. Okay. So this value basically when we draw this thing, so without when consider the there is a no noise, so it will give us the plus mean value equal to this. What is the mean value for this? Sorry, this is the mean value for the W equal to 0. So if we want to consider the mean value for the signal observation element S1 and S2, so the mean value will be plus minus square root of E/2. And in this case, minus plus square root of E/2. So this is the mean value for these two observation elements. Okay. Okay. So now, previously, as we discussed, when we discuss about the binary PSK, so we have seen there is a, we got the value of P is equal to function of, what was the function of Q of 2? EB/N0. So what was the value of P probability of error for the BPSK? Error probability for the BPSK was Q function of 2 EB/N0. So now there was a single bit was transmitting, and now we are transmitting two bits together. So basically the square root of energy by N0, that Q function of this value will give us the error P value. Okay. And E is replaced by the E2B over there, as I told. So now if we want to take the average correction detection, that means average probability of a correct detection, so for that what we can get, the E equal to PE, that's equal to 1 minus E prime whole square. So this value, and if we put the prime value over there, so we'll get the PE value, sorry, PC value, P correct, means correct detection, probability of correct detection means PC, we denoted by the PC. So PC will get, the PC equal to 1 minus P prime. Okay. Now if we put those value over there, and if we solve this, so we'll get that expression. There you go. So we'll get that expression. Is that clear or there is a doubt? So I hope there should be a doubt that why we are getting the squared terms over there. So thing is that for on channel, we have the value of these. For the channel also we have the same correct detection probability value, 1 minus P prime. These two, when we will multiply these two, it will come the squared term. Okay, so just I put the value instead of the P prime, we put the value of the Q function, and we represent this in terms of the Q function. So now this is the value for correct detection, means the correct detection of the bit. Okay, so now if we want to calculate the average probability of symbol error, so average probability of the symbol error equal to 1 minus correct detection. Okay, so PE equal to 1 minus PC. So that means we will get, if we put the PC over there, we will get that term. So this is the your probability of symbols error. So this is not the probability of bit error, this is the probability of symbols error. Okay, anyone have any doubt? So now if some region where that E by N naught is very very larger than 1, so in that case we can ignore this term. Okay, and the condition is that E by N naught, it should be very very larger than 1. So if we ignore these terms, what will be the remaining? And the average value, so basically the average value, it will be PE to equal to 2Q square root of E by N naught. So we are getting the this value, and the condition should be there. The condition, what is the condition is there, that E by N naught is very very larger than 1. So in that case we can ignore the quadratic term from this PE. Okay, okay. So now if we just see the figure in the signal space diagram, okay, so signal space diagram, when we have the sum any value, or what is the nearest point, suppose we consider the two things, one is your say the point is the M1, okay, so this point we consider. So what is the nearest two point of this? There may be a M4 or M2. This is the two nearest point of your M1. Okay. So now, some case, what should be the error may occur. Suppose we are transmitting a symbol of say M1, but there is a probability to have the value either M4 or M2. because these two point are the nearest to your M1. Okay, that means whatever the error we'll get only by these two value. Okay, so now if we calculate the distance, that equidistance, and definitely these two message point have the same. Okay, so actually there is one question, why we ignoring the quadratic term. So basically the quadratic term is ignored, so it is very very means the condition. So the problem, okay, so there is a question, the question is that why we ignore that quadratic term from this equation. So the thing is that when we are considering the special case that e by n is very very greater than 0, in that case it will give us the almost zero value. So when this value is very small, we can ignore. That's why we are ignoring this quadratic term, and we have seen that previously when we are increasing this value, the overall quadratic function value, sorry, q function value is reducing the value when you increase the value inside the q function. So last day, so that means that value, when we increase that value, or this value is very very greater than 1, in that case this value will reduce, and it will say almost approximately to your zero or near to zero. So when it is very very small, we can ignore that term. Okay, okay, as I was talking about the distance, so that means whenever there is a error, so suppose previously we have seen there was a two states there, one is 0 and one is 1. So if there is a error, that means one may get when we transmit 0, we may get as a 1, when we are transmitting 1, we can get as a 0. So that was the condition when we transmit the binary or BPSK signal. Okay, but in that case there is a four message point is there. So now when we transmit a message signal, say M1, what are the chance for getting M2 or M4? These two point or these two message point are the nearest to M1. Okay, so that means we may get these two value. Okay, so now if we calculate the distance, equidistance, and definitely if we look at the distance, these message point distance from both M2 and M4, all are the equidistance, means both are the same. And this equidistant sense, in equidistant sense, what is the value D12 and D14? If you want to calculate, and this value will be your square root of 2e. Square root of 2e, that's okay, square root of 2e. So this is, you can multiply. Okay, so this will be the value, we will get the square root of 2e when we calculate the distance from 1 to 2, and it will be same as your d 1 to 4. Okay, from this figure, and that value will be your square root of 2e. And we are ignoring this point because this is, we can ignore that point is quite means this distance. Suppose if we calculate, this is the boundary, okay, This is the boundary. So now the error of getting some value over there, the probability will be very less compared to this getting or having some value, these two values. Okay. So that means we are ignoring, that's why we are ignoring the M3. So now as we discussed that we are sending a pair of bits, so that means if what is the value of E over there, so E basically it will be the two times of your EB thing energy. EB is the energy per bit, so that means E is the twice of the energy per bit, signal energy per bit. So we can write this term, yes or no? So that means if we put the E value in this your PE, so we can write the PE is equal to approximately 2Q square root of 2EB by N naught, which is the So now from there, if we find the previously that what is the BER for the QPSK. Okay, so we'll get the BER that's equal to Q of BER equal to, this is the BER when we discuss about the your BPSK, that time we have seen the BPSK, what was the BER? Bit error rate. Anyone? Basically that we'll get the BER equal to this form, and these two we'll ignore because we are using the gray coding, and in the gray coding, suppose we say 00. And if we see this figure, it will be clear to you. Okay. So you've seen when we consider the there is a, suppose we got the M4, so how many bits of error is there? Only one bit, because there is a only we are using the gray coding, so that means consecutive two cells there is a single bit of error. That's why the BER will be half of your probability of error. Is that means clear that when we discuss about your bit error rate for the BPSK, we have seen what is the BP bit error rate is same as the probability of error. Okay, but in this case, since we are using the gray coding and there is only one bit of change, so only we are sending two bits and we are getting either this value or this value, whatever the value we'll get, there is a single bit of error. So that means we are reducing the bit error rate by half. That's why the bit error rate will be half of your probability of error. And we have seen the probability of error equal to approximately 2 q function of square root 2b, 2eb by n naught. So now that means we can write the bit error rate that's equal to your Q function of square root of 2EB by N naught. Okay. So is there any doubt up to this? No. And that QPSK is almost your like the when you discuss the BPSK, BPSK is similar to your DSBSC signal, and QPSK is similar to your QAM signal, quadrature amplitude modulation signal. Focus is both are the similar kind of thing. So now if we want to discuss the power spectrum of the QPSK signal, normally when we calculating the power spectrum of the QPSK signal, we have considered that both the symbol has the equal probability. Okay, and depending on the debate during the signaling interval. So we have the signaling interval minus TB to plus TB. This is the signaling interval, and we are transmitting a debit signal. That means combined of two speeds. So that is called the debit. So now there is in phase, and we have seen there is a two channel. One is the in phase channel, and there is a quadrate channel. So suppose if the in phase component equals to either plus GT or minus GT, okay. So just we are representing the whatever the component in the in phase channel. So we representing either using the plus GT or minus GT. Similarly, we represent the quadratic component also. And that GT is denoted by this function, GT equal to within 0 to T, it is square root of E by T, otherwise it is 0. So that means we can say that GT is basically a square, your pulse signal, rectangular pulse, okay? Okay, within this time duration, this is the amplitude of the GT. So now if we do, suppose this is your PT, the pulse signal PT, okay, or okay, leave it, GT is there. So now if we calculate the GT is equal to your rectangular pulse. Now if we do the Fourier transform, so what we will get? G of F, that will be a, so what we will get? Sync function, we will get the sync function. Sync of, what is the component we will get? The sync of T of F, because we are taking the time duration T and F is the frequency. Okay. And there will definitely, since there will be a terms of E, the amplitude of the GF. Okay, so this is the Fourier transform of the GT or a rectangular pulse. Now when we take the power spectrum density, we know the power spectrum density is B of F. That's equal to mod of, sorry, it will be the capital G. G of F. Square. By. T. So basically now, if we want to calculate that term, so what we will use that G square is there. That means we can find out the power spectrum density, and okay, there will be a terms, ET will be there. Okay, so basically what will happen, from there we'll get the, this term is there. So finally we are getting the power spectrum equation, that's equal to E sine square FT. So that's why there is a quiet term in the sync function. Okay. So, and this sync function is present for the both the component, in phase component and the quadrature component. Okay. So now the two symbols which is transmitting through the your in phase component or is in phase channel or quadratic channel. So that means we can say the in phase component and the quadratic component, they are statistically independent. So that means we can add the power spectrum of these two different channels together to get the overall power spectrum density of the QPSK signal. So that means if we add these two terms, means two times of this, so that means finally we'll get the power spectrum density, this equal to two times of that value. So we get that expression, that S of F, that's equal to 2E psi sin square PF. And we know how many bits we are, means what is the value of E equal to 2EB? E equal to 2EB. So now we put that value over there. What is the EB over here? EB is the bit energy per bit. Okay. So if we put those value, we'll get there. And in this figure, what we did, in that we normalized the power spectrum density by 4EB, because the maximum value of this term or this equation equal to 4EB. So we normalized the power spectrum density by the 4EB, whatever the value. And in the x-axis, that is the normalized frequency. And what is the normalized frequency? It is a, we normalize the frequency in terms of 2TB by TB into F. Okay, using this term, we normalize the frequency. Now, if we plot that, so we'll get the curve like this. Okay, so this is the power spectrum density curve for the your QPSK signal. So the there are another plot also is there, the MSK. MSK is your basically the minimum shift keying, which is the same as the binary phase shift keying. Means both are same. Binary FSK. FSK. So we'll discuss later about the MSK. And if we draw the spectrum for the BFSK or MSK, we'll get the spectrum look like this, and we put that both the signal or spectrum over here for a comparison purpose. Okay, in this figure they put over here. Okay, so now definitely when we transmit the symbols through this channel, that time there is a QPSK signal. Okay, so already I discussed, when I discussed this figure, so how much, okay, let me open the figure. Okay, so when I discuss about this figure, that time we have seen there is a 180 degree phase shift when there is a change in both the channel sequence, that means in phase component and your quadric component. So when there is a change, then there is a 180 phase shift. And when there is a only one value is changing, okay, in this example, in this point, you see it changed 0 to 1, 1 to 0. I mean, both the channel is changed. So there is, that means in this point, there is a 180 degree phase shift. So now in this point, this channel is not changing any value. So 0 to 0. Now here there is a one change, that means there is a phase shift of a, in this point, phase shift of a 90 degree. And when there is a no change, either both the channel, this channel or this channel, see, in that case, there will be no phase change. So that's why there is a no phase change. So these are the three conditions we are getting over there. Okay. This is explained. Okay. So this thing, now the situation is that for the first case, when there is a 180 degree of phase shift, 180 degree of phase shift, that case, in that case, the probability of generation of that case is lesser. And situation two, that means when there is a 90 degree plus minus 90 degree phase shift, you see, as I the last day someone asked me one question, that how much phase shift will be, it is plus or minus. So if you look at the phase change over there, there is a both plus minus is there. So it is depending on the, as I told last class also, depending on that, it is how it is changing. It is 0 to 1 or 1 to 0. So depending on that, that value will occur either positive phase change or negative phase change. So, okay. So now the thing is that when we are generating this, there is a phase shift. So in that case, there is a quadratic delay component. So in this, basically when we are due to this phase change, there is a possibility of a variant of the QPS case, and basically it is generating the quadratic component in delay. So whatever the component we are getting, so there will be a delay option of that, and the delay is the how much delay will be there. The delay is the half of the symbols interval with respect to the bit stream. Okay, so now to overcome this delay, that means when basically phase shift is there. So in these two cases, there is a phase shift, and due to this phase shift, there is a variation of the amplitude. Okay, so now our objective in the FSK is that, or the definition of the FSK is that, the phase of the carrier signal will change, but the amplitude of the carrier signal should not change. That is the normal definition of the QPSK. But when we are on PSK, normal BPSK, so now when we are doing the QPSK signaling, in that case there is a delay or there is a phase change. So due to this phase change, there is a fluctuation in the amplitude. Okay, so that means there is a drawback of the normal QPSK. So to overcome the normal drawback of the QPSK, there is a on scheme which is called the offset QPSK. So in the offset QPSK, what we are doing? So when we discuss about the QPSK, we consider the two basic function. On basic function equal to this, the phi 1 t, that's equal to square root of 2 by t cos 2 pi fct, and it is within range of 0 to t. And second one was phi 2 t, that's the same value, means whatever the basic function we consider for the both case, this and this, the value are the same, but we change the duration. So previously when we discuss about the normal QPSK, so both the case, the time within t within 0 to t. But in that case, in the offset QPSK, what we are doing, we are quadratic component is delayed by the t by 2 time. So that means we are getting the value from this duration with this interval. Is that clear? Okay. So now, when we are considering the delay, there is a delay in the Q2 component, means a phi 2t, that is quadratic component. So that equation of the amplitude. Okay, so this is the figure. How this for your will pass switching between the your message point, the normal QPSK and FSK. Okay, so the diagonal portion is not there over for the offset value, offset QPSK. Okay, so that means in the offset, what we are doing, we are shifting the basic function phi 2 with a delay of t by 2. Okay, by doing this, we can improve the disadvantage, or we can mitigate the amplitude fluctuation. Okay.